Disclaimer. I do not own the rights to music contained in this video. On behalf of the family, we would like to thank all our family, friends, and well-wishers for their support and encouraging words on all social media platforms. We hope and pray that you will live life to its fullness, in love and unity. We give a special thanks to all the staff at the New Haven Funeral Center for their professionalism and outstanding services. Rosetta has gone home, but her memories and legacy lives on. Thank you.
I pray that we're Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. We will be starting service shortly. I'm just going to kindly ask that those who haven't paid their final respects, please do so now, as the casket will be closing around 10:55 or 10:58. Thank you. For those speaking during service, I'm going to kindly ask you to use this microphone only. Pastor will have his own microphone so that we can be separated. And we will be starting service a few minutes earlier, so if you have not done so, kindly make your way to pay your final respects right now. Thank you. Thank you.
That song look a bit better. Wow. My name is Bishop Bourne, and I will be doing the honors this morning of sending home our loved one to the bereaved family, to everyone that is meeting here today to show your support. I extend greetings in the name of Jesus. We are gathered here to see to the homegoing of our sister departed, Rosetta Kerr. Not sure what names most of you would have known her by, but if you are at any at all Jamaican or have some sort of Jamaican connection, you will know there's some sort of a nickname somewhere there. Am I right? So I'm almost sure that there is a name somewhere along the line that she would have been called outside of Rosetta. And if I know my Jamaican people well, we know how to not call people name correctly. Especially if you have a name like mine that everybody knows, but they purposely giving me a different type of name, you know. But I'm honored this morning, more so humbled, to be gathered with you. The gathering may not be one of all joy. It may not be one of all smiles. It may be one where a lot of tears may be shed. But there is a writer that declares that tears are a language that God understands. Anybody know what I'm talking about here? Amen? And you don't need to sit down and just close up your mouth and you can say amen. And if you go to church, anybody go to church?
Amen.
Yes, man. Bless the name of the Lord. Sister Rosie, all right? Praise God. You're white. You look pretty though. All right, I'm going to get to this because they tell me that my time is very limited in this place. And that is why I don't like to come to funerals because, you know, I am a Jamaican, you know, and we don't really know good timing and we don't work well with time. Am I right?
Yeah.
Yeah, we like to just get things and do things our way, and we don't stop until when we feel fully satisfied that it gets done properly. Huh? Help me now, man. Yeah, man. So if maybe when the funeral people come to take us out, just close the door and say, listen, make we finish with thing right. We can't do that, right? All right. Okay, we're going to get to it. Bless God. And I just want you just to, you know, let us do this together. If we cooperate ourselves and sing together and, you know, lively up ourselves and not feel so down. The Bible declares that weeping may endure but for a night. Amen. But joy comes in the morning. Oh, praise the Lord. So when we have that hope of that morning joy, then we can rejoice. Amen. 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 Bless the name of the Lord. I am going to, praise God, invite Mr. Shauna Vassell, Deaconess Vassell, is she here? To do the opening prayer. If you would bow your head with me as we're going to pray at this moment, as we are going to get ready for our program and our service. Father, in the name of Jesus, we give you glory and we give you honor this morning. We thank you, Lord, for life, especially for those of us who are still breathing. We thank you, Lord, that when we got up this morning, Lord, we were afforded the privilege, Lord, of our blood still being running warm through our veins, and the limbs in our bodies are able to move, and we can speak and we can hear and we can feel. We thank you, Lord, because it's only by your help and only by your grace that we are still here. We also thank you, God, for the life that your daughter has lived, and that no, God, she has expired from this life and you have called her home. And so, God, as we come today to celebrate the life she lived, we pray that your presence, God, will be with us today. And we ask in the name of Jesus that everything that is said and done will be done in the honor and the glory of your name. More so, God, give the family members, close friends, those who knew her, those who come to support, give us the strength. Give us the strength, oh God, to deal with the moments such as this. Hear my prayer again as we tell you thanks in Jesus' name. Come on, can the church say? Come on, can we say? Bless the name of the Lord. I'm going to invite you to stand with me. And if you got one of these pretty program booklets, funeral booklets or whatever they want to call them, but bless God, we're going to sing the hymn, How Great Thou Art. Somebody clap your hands. Come on, clap your hands and give God praise. We are singing How Great Thou Art. We're talking about God of alone. He who created heaven and earth, how great thou art, how great thou art. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord. You may be seated. Oh, praise God. Praise God. At this time, we're going to be having the first scripture reading, which will be done by Sefling Lang.
Now we are going to read from Psalms 91. Yes. He that dwell in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flee by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasted at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand. But it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eyes shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation, there shall be no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For he shall give his angel charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lions and other. The young lions and the dragon shall thou trample under feet. Because he hath set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high, because he hath known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. Those was the words of the Lord.
Amen. Praise the name of the Lord.
This is your main prayer. And I pray that you continue in heaven with this prayer.
Amen. Amen. Right at this time, we'll be hearing the first tribute, which will be done by Darmet Williams, a family friend.
I know Mama Shirley for many years. She was a person that was always helping others in many different ways, whether to comfort or to pray with them or counsel them to read their Bibles. She always said it was a tool of wisdom and comfort. During the last couple of years after my mom passing, I confided in her during my emotional time. I remember she said I could call her Mama. She was always there when I needed her sometimes to talk to. She would call me in the early morning and spoke about her youthful days and would say, Mama, I was praying for you. When you heard your ears ringing, it's your Mama Shirley interceding on your behalf. I was praying for all my children and grandchildren and friends. I know she was a God-fearing mother, aunt, and friend. She was a strong and courageous person to all friends and family. That early Friday morning, while I was lying in my bed, I heard a voice say, pray for me. I arose and said, who are you? What's your name? I never knew the voice of Mama Shirley. Sleep, my beloved Mama. Shirley, we love you dearly, but Jesus loves you best. Peace. Amen.
Thank you, Darmet Williams, for such a wonderful tribute. I love what I'm seeing here today, this type of gathering. It speaks volume of the life that our deceased, our mother has lived. And if it's only for this, then we can surely say that she lived a good life. Am I right in here? I would love to think that she lived an exemplary life. Amen. And I want to believe that is why so many of us are here today. I would love and I would hope that whatever we are saying here today, that we would have already said some of these to her before she passed. Because right now, whatever we say, she can't hear it. Amen. She's gone to a place where someday soon to come, we're going to tread that road also. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Come on, somebody praise God. Somebody praise Him. So we gotta ensure that the life we live here is proper. Am I right? We gotta ensure that the life we live here, praise God, it's good. Amen. So that when we are gone, somebody may have something good to say about us, because maybe that is just what our legacy will be. Many of us won't die to leave money or big houses or cars to give anybody. Am I right? But one thing we can ensure is that if we lived properly, somebody will remember the life that we lived. Amen? Amen? Come on, clap your hands with me, man. If I had a wing like a dove. Any Jamaican in the house? Come on, any church people here? Where are my church people? Open them out, help me to sing. If I had a wing like a dove, I would fly, fly away, fly away and give God rest. You see what happened just now? My mouth is so big, you know. that I am anointed the next dead in the next room. Amen. Yeah, man, when we sing, we need to sing to keep ourselves alive. Amen. I would fly. Come on, come with me, man. Fly away. Fly away and give God rest. Amen. 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 Bless the name of the Lord. The only death that is in here is in the casket. Bless the name of the Lord. So if you are alive and open your mouth and sing, man, I would fly, fly away. Fly away and give God rest. Bless the name of the Lord. Amen. I'm pretty sure, but I hope there's a music producer in the house who can maybe sign me up in there, you know, in the studio. What are you trying to say? I can't sing? Huh? Well, if you don't think I can sing, I know I can sing. Huh? Yo, man, I love me more than all you love me. So I appreciate me. I can sing. I will fly. Fly away. Fly away. And give God rest. Amen. Did somebody just say, I am good? I hear that, you know. I got good hearing. Oh, bless God. Come on, we're going to give God some praise in here. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Oh, praise God. Let me get on with this. Amen. I can stay here all day. You all need to come to my church one of these days. Yeah, man. And you know, they can say, yeah, man, we're going to send over to Sony or to MGM or somebody to sign you up. Huh? Or one of them bad boy record producers they have in Jamaica. You can probably send me to one of them, right? Where's your sister Rose? Yeah. All right. Amen. Right away, we're going to have the second scripture reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 52-58 by the granddaughter, Trisha Campbell. Is Trisha here? Wow, this is the first funeral. We come with so much pretty lady there, you know. I hope we live good and keep that beauty. Want to smile, no man? Sure, I'm going to come and show me a talk. Why was the way becoming a pastor and think me blind?
God of my life. So I'll be reading 1 Corinthians 15, verse 50-58. It says, now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, neither doth corruption inherit incorruption. Behold, I shew you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Amen. And these are my few words.
Amen. Come on, say amen.
Amen.
Come on, say amen.
Amen.
Bless the name of the Lord. Praise God. We're going to move on with the next congregational hymn that reads, He leadeth me. Auntie, you still here? Come, man. You need to come help me. Come, Auntie, come. I know you're not get tired yet. Bless the name of the Lord. And if there's anybody else who knows to sing good, you can stand up and open your mouth, you know.
But I don't really know this one, so somebody else want to come and help me sing it.
Let me help you. Then.
Start it, Bishop.
Help you. Amen. Okay. He leadeth me.
He leaded me. His faithful follower I will be, for by his hand he'll lead me.
Bless the name of the Lord. Praise God. At this time, we will be hearing a tribute by the nephew, Hezekiah Campbell. Well, I don't give you a very young name.
Ladies and gentlemen, relatives, friends, and loved ones of my dear Aunt Shirley. I have known my Aunt Shirley all of my life. There's always a special bond between me and Aunt. When I pick up the phone at times and I called Aunt, the volume seems to be low. But as soon as Aunt recognized my voice, the volume went all the way up. There is always a flower to grow among the thorn, to live and die among the thorn. My aunt is one of those flowers that live and grow and die among the thorn. While in the midst of the thorn, she have left many seeds to grow. I thank God for the privilege of having a aunt like Aunt Shirley. Aunt Shirley is the longest survivor of the family. I consider her to be the history book. My auntie had a memory like a good written book. I'm sad to say that there's no one of her knowledge that I can ask the family history and get an answer. But I thank God for the time that I live and for the time that I know Aunt. I too have an unending memory of my auntie. One that I know for sure that she gets along with everybody, from what you're seeing here, can tell. And I'm happy to know that my auntie lived a life that someone recognized. There's so much to say about my aunt. But one thing I'm glad that all that I know about my aunt, I was privileged to, every time that I would visit my aunt, and before I left her, I would left her with some of the God-given gifts and privilege that I have. I would lay my hands on her and I would pray for her. And today, she is no more. a flower in the town. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Shilomoko sha. Shikiyomoko shikiyamo. Lomoko sha. Yalomoko shikiyomoko shikiyao. Lomo. Ilomoko shilomo. She's no more. A flower among the thorn. But I believe with all my heart that she's at rest. And before I take my seat, this is a song that I learned from my aunt. I don't know if I learned it all. And many of you never hear it. Last night as I lay on my pillow, last night as I lay on my bed, last night as I lay on my pillow, I dreamt that my Bonnie was there. Yes, my Bonnie is over the ocean. My Bonnie is over the sea. My Bonnie is over the ocean. Ah, please bring back my Bonnie to me. Bring back, oh, bring back my Bonnie to me, bring back, oh, bring back my Bonnie to me, bring back, oh, bring back my Bonnie to me. Now let me tell you this, this is me so sad. That Bonnie not coming to you. You have to go to be with that Bonnie. And you know, I want to tell you this, what I believe. To me, death is not a disappointment. Death is an appointment. Are you here? I said, death is not a disappointment. Death is an appointment. For it is appointed unto man once to die, and after death come the judgment. Thank you all. Thank you all. God bless you all.
I see why the name is Hezekiah. Oh, bless God. Oh, praise God. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Those are wonderful words. I'm still trying to hear what the song says. It's bring back my body or my bunny or my belly to me. My honey. My bunny. Master Hezekiah. Melissa Hezekiah, you'll have to explain me that a little more of that song after we finish here today, huh? Amen? Yeah, man, I want to learn that song. Yeah, man, it seems as if I have competition leading to the studio, you know? Come on, put your hands together and clap your hands, man. Yes. Bless God. I told you earlier that the only deceased that's in this room is who is in the casket. Amen. So we gotta act as if we're alive. We gotta behave as if we're alive. We gotta move as if we are alive. Amen. And appreciate the fact that we are alive. Somebody praise God up in here. Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. We will be hearing the eulogy at this time. And Gladys Leng is coming to read the eulogy. Put your hands together for her. Come on, sound alive, man. Sound alive.
Good day, everyone. My name is Gladys Lang Davis. I'm the third child for Rosetta. To everything, there's a season, a time to every purpose under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away. These are the words coming from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, from verses 1 through to 6. Rosetta Kerr, fondly remembered as Shirley, aunt, cousin, and grandma, was the seventh of eight children born to Isadora Smith and William Kerr on December 23rd, 1926, in the district of Crofts Hill, Clarendon, Jamaica, West Indies. Rosetta grew up in a humble setting. Although her academic desires and aspirations to become a seamstress were not fulfilled, she drew strength from doing whatever her hands found to do. The beautiful sheet sets, pillowcases, and house dresses that she made attest to the fact that she could turn any material that she got into something that was beautiful and worthy of admiration. In 1969, she migrated to Canada in search of a better life. She worked tirelessly as a caregiver and housekeeper. Her goal was to have her children, who were left in Jamaica, join her in Toronto, where she resided. She experienced many challenges and hardship. However, she managed to sponsor four children as soon as she could. Two settled in the United States. Despite the hardship and challenges that Rosetta faced, every morning at 5 a.m. was dedicated in praying to God on behalf of her children and others. She would call her children's name one by one. She has left a great legacy in the form of an advice stating, "Live good with who you can live. No met nobody bother you." And if you were a female, she would say, "No let nobody bother you, yeah, mommy." Our mom had a sharp memory. At the age of 94, she was able to repeat the 91st Psalm, which was her favorite psalm. She remembered the phone number of her children and others too. Rosetta demonstrated great courage and resilience in her later years. Although she complained of arthritic pain in her feet, they were just as sharp as her brain. On her 91st birthday, she showed off her moves, dancing in heels with her oldest grandson. She wouldn't have it any other way. At my wedding, all eyes were on her as she put on a show on the dance floor. She went all out doing the scare. Lasting memories of her mother will live on. She was a hard-working, passionate figure of determination and strength, who never withdrew her support for others. One who soldiered on, even when the tides were high. She lived a full life, filled with humor, advice, and gems of instructions. Memories of her will live forever in the hearts of the generation she has left behind. Left to grieve are her children, Lenford, Pauline, Gladys, Cephalin, Letla, daughter-in-law Ruth, sons-in-law Lenworth, Audley, Fabian, 14 grandchildren, 20 great-grandchildren, nieces, nephews, grandnieces, and grandnephews, as well as other relatives, and a host of cherished friends. Let this be a loving reminder that someone is missing today, someone our hearts still hold on to as we travel along life's way, someone whose life was special for those who gather here, someone who won't be forgotten but cherished from year to year. And now as we pause to remember, let us fondly recall how much we love and how she loved us all. May her memory be a blessing. Rest in peace, Mother. God bless you.
Thank you, Gladys. Those were really touching words and a touching reminder of your mother. And I realize, and this is from experience, not that I've lost my mother, thank God she's still here, but I've lost a few loved ones. And I'm still realizing that it's never the easiest thing to say goodbye. In as much as we recognize that, as Brother Hezekiah said earlier, death is not a disappointment, but an appointment. And this is via the word of the Lord, where it reminds us that man that is born of a woman, according to the scripture, have but a short time to live, and his days is full of trouble. Oh, praise God. Oh, praise God. And that is a declaration that we are not here forever. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. We are born, we live, and surely at some point we will die. The Bible says it is appointed unto a man. And for those of you ladies who think that it doesn't refer to you, so some of you all live as if you own a life, and I don't blame you either, but you gotta recognize that you don't need to show off on anybody, because we're all gonna die one day. Amen. It's appointed unto a man, mankind, humanity, once to die. But after death comes the judgment. That is when everything that you have done, everything that we have done, we must give account for such. Do I have a witness in here? In briefly speaking to you this afternoon, rather this morning, the dead can't hear. And I sat and I listened of the prayers that she would have prayed. And I've listened to the beliefs of those who have spoken that she is resting comfortably somewhere with God. And that's some level of assurance to me that she knew the Lord for herself. Amen. And she would, if I'm hearing correctly, she would ensure that anyone that she was in contact with knew the same God that she knew. You can correct me if I'm wrong here. I am happy to have met her. prayed with her, talked with her. Amen. And had it been possible, she would have been in church a few times because that was her desire. But ill health would not have allowed it. That still didn't stop her from remembering who her God is. Amen. I want to briefly remind you of a story, biblical story, that is from the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 4. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. And it reminds us of a woman, a great woman, that lived in a city called Shunem. For those of you who are Bible readers, you know what I'm talking about. Amen. And the Bible declares that this woman had no children. But it didn't stop her from being caring. It didn't stop her from recognizing that if someone had a need, she would extend a helping hand. Oh, bless God. And so the story would have said that the man of God, Elisha, would have passed by her house quite often. And she recognized him, that he was not no ordinary person. I am believing that Rosetta was no ordinary individual. Amen, church. And I want us to live our lives in the sense that we are seen and known as extraordinary individuals. And when I say extraordinary, I mean we're not just living, amen, just by our name. Because if you are living and your life is not impacting somebody else's life in a positive manner, you have not yet started living. Amen. You in life, oh bless God, cannot only live for yourself. And we have heard many stories of folks who have come to this country and have opened their doors to many who have no maternal connection to them. Oh bless God. And so this woman recognized the man of God, that he was no ordinary individual. And the Bible said, she said to her husband, "Husband, I realize this man is a special man. Let us ensure that we prepare a place for him so he can get some rest every time he passes by this place." Oh, bless the Lord. I want us to realize, people of God, that every time we extend a hand of good, every time that we exercise love, because that's what it is, at some point or time in your life, it will come back. And if you don't experience it, your children will. If you don't experience it, your grandchildren will. I often hear the older folks in Jamaica saying that the good you do today will follow you tomorrow. I am sure that Rosetta, amen, lived and did some good. It's why we are all here, to remember the good she has done. As hard as life would have presented itself, because I don't know anybody who come to this country and get anything easy. Even if you're juggling on the corner, it's still rough. I don't seem as if I have any witness up in here. Many of us who have come to this country, we came with hopes, oh praise God, to reach a certain status. But many of us, we haven't gotten there, but we have still survived. Amen. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. The Bible said that this woman, amen, she prepared a room and she ensured that the settings were comfortable for the man of God and his servant. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. And so the story would have told us that, amen, when Elisha looked around and wondered, why is it you're doing all this good? Is there anything I can do for you? The woman said, I am all good. I have it all together. Oh, praise the name of Jesus. And so the man of God looked around and said to his servants, take a look around again, man, and figure out what I can do for this woman. And he came back with a report. I don't hear no children. I don't hear no little feet running around. Anybody in here who have children? Any parent is in the house? And all when them miserable and all when them take away your things and all when them do all kind of something, you still love them because they are yours, am I right? Even when they're disappointed, they are still yours, am I right? Even when they bring them where they're not supposed to bring them, they are still yours, am I right? Oh, somebody praise the name of the Lord. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. Even when the cops knock on your door, when you don't expect them to, but the child is still yours. Oh, Lord, help me. Hallelujah. The servant of the man of God said, I don't hear no children. And so he understood that something was missing. The eulogist said she took up her four children. Am I right? Huh? Some stay, some is in the Big Apple. And some stayed here. And a pretty white-haired lady over here. Amen. Even under the mask, she's still pretty, you know. I hear you. Say it again. Say amen again loudly. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. And the man sit down beside her and I tell him every day he needs to come to church. He's still a reach yet, you know. He's coming tomorrow. All right. You can't not come in, or somebody say you're coming tomorrow. See, nobody answer, you know. Amen. But however, the man of God says, listen, Shunammite woman, 9 months after today, you will have a child. And I'm going to finish very quickly. You will have a child. And this woman must have said, saying to herself, what is this man talking about? Me? I'm good. I'm comfortable. I have all that I have, all that I want. But the man of God says, you go have a child. Have you ever hoped and believed and wished for some stuff that seemed impossible? Do I have any witness in here that look as if it will not happen, but somehow God bring it through for you? Oh, glory to God. Your child needed to go to college. You don't know how the money was gonna come, but somehow God brought it through for you. Hallelujah. You don't know where the mortgage money is going to come from next month. And you've been scratching your head, but you believe in God and he brought it through for you. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. The woman heard what the man of God said. And 9 months later, I don't know how often she and her husband got in bed. I know it was no immaculate conception like Jesus. Hello? Oh God. I'm talking to some folks who don't understand what I'm saying. Amen. I don't know if they did it every day, morning or evening. But 9 months later, a baby was prepared to be born. Never got a witness in here. Hallelujah. The Bible said that the child grew up to a certain age. And I'm coming to the point I'm trying to get to here. The child got to a certain age, and the Bible said that the child was in the field with its father. Any fathers in the house? Any fathers in the house? Maybe let me put up my two hands. But if I start counting my children, you'll start running. Amen. Any fathers in the house? I know sometimes, yes, I have a few moments. I can still chat a little bit more. I know sometimes for those of us who work with some companies, there are certain times when they allow us to take our children to work with us. Yeah? Am I right? And many of us as parents, it is a proudest moment to take your child to work with you. Amen? The Bible said that the day that came when the child was, praise God, out in the field working with his father. And he died. He got sunstruck. And I don't want to trouble anybody up in here. But for those people who like to bleach out them skin, your skin have no protection from the sun. I hope there's nobody here. My friend, are you all right? You good? I know you may talk though. We're trying to find somebody in here that look like them skin tone much lighter than it should be. Listen, your back turned to the congregation. You can't see behind you. I am I here still? Do I need to put a helmet on when I'm leaving? The Bible said that he got sunstruck and he died. So the father took the child and brought him back to his mother. Right there, but you need to tell somebody, I am not ready to mourn. I am going to live. I hear David said, I shall not die, but live and declare. Oh, somebody praise God up in here. You need to shout and let somebody know, I am going to live until when God said, my time is expired. Oh, praise God. Don't let it seem as if everybody who smile with you wants you to live. Don't let it seem as if everybody who shake your hand wants you to live. Some would hope that you drop down and dead. Same place and same time. But you need to say to somebody, I am not yet ready to mourn. I am going to live. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. So when they can stand to see you, let me talk to the people who like to fix up themselves. Amen. Especially those who have the nice curves. So when you walk in, amen, even if you don't see nobody to show it off and you're just rocking it. Because you know what God bless you. You know how much God bless you. Amen. And you know when you're rocking, you're so tenderly watching you. What about the psalm says, he that dwelleth. So when you're rocking at the enemy, looking at you, wanting to drop them and dead. Just ask about he that dwelleth. Amen. In the secret place. That was a favorite song, am I right? In the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Oh, somebody praise God. The Bible said that when the son was brought back to his mother, she was not yet ready to mourn. Oh, somebody praise God. She took the child. Oh, praise God. And she brought him and laid him on the bed of the prophet in the room she had provided. You see, you got to believe God for what he's able to do. You got to believe God for what the possibilities with him are. Because with God, nothing is impossible. Somebody lift up the name of Jesus. Our very existence here, amen, it is proof that with God, nothing at all is impossible. It no matter what they say, we know the God whom we serve. Oh, somebody praise God. He is the creator of heaven and earth. Amen. When this earth was without form or void, he spoke the word and it came to be. Oh, praise God. Watch this. He was not breathing, but she was not yet ready to mourn. So she did not go to get the undertaker. She did not go to get the doctor to pronounce him dead. Somebody praise God. Because she was not yet ready to mourn. Oh, glory be to God. Amen. The Bible said that she, amen, put him on the bed and she left him there because of her faith in God. I want somebody to lift their faith in God today. Amen. And realize that you may be going through a tough time. You may be going through some serious situation, or you have issues that seem as if it can't be fixed. But there's a God who reigns above. There's a God who says, my child, amen, amen, the night is not as dark as it seems to be, because I got it in my hands and I got you covered. One verse in the psalm says that he will give his angels charge over you to keep you in all of your ways. Is a church here? Is a church here? And so the Bible says that, oh, praise God, she said to one of the servants, one of the young men, get me an ass, saddle him up for me. Oh, praise God. Amen. And fix him good, because I'm going on a journey. And amen, I don't care how rough the road get, but don't stop riding. Don't stop moving unless I bid you. Sometimes life get uncomfortable. It don't mean you should give up. Amen. It may just be a challenge. Amen. To prove how strong you are. How resilient you are, and that you can survive the next day. Amen. She lived as long as she lived because of her resilience. And for those of you who are caregivers and household workers, amen, you will understand that those type of jobs is not easy. It's not for the faint heart. Am I right up in here? She would have had many challenges, but she went through and she survived. Amen. And she lived until when the Lord decided it was her time to go. The Bible said that the woman, amen, said, and slacken not your riding unless I bid thee. Oh, praise God. And the verse in the scripture. Verse 27, a lot of verse of it says, when she got to where the man of God was, because she had a mission, she was not yet ready to mourn. She said, I'm going to go back to the man who spoke life to me, because somehow he must have a connection with the life giver. I am going back to find the man, amen, who spoke life to me when I had no children. He got to go back and talk to the man, oh, praise God, and tell him that I want my child back. When your children find themselves in some situation, amen, and the system get a hold on them and try to strangle them, listen, man, tell God the child is mine. You gave him or her to me, and I want them back. Too many of us are giving up too easily. And yes, sometimes they walk out of our directives. Amen. It don't mean that we're going to give up on them. I hear that song we sing in church all the time, down on my knees. I don't have anybody who know that song. When sorrow rise, I will talk to Jesus. Down on my knees, I promise him that I will serve him. The Bible said she found the man of God. And he would have sent his servant to find out if everything is all right. And watch this. When he got down there, amen, she said to Gehazi, listen, it is well. Only when you have confidence in the Lord. Yes, I have 5 more minutes. Only when you have confidence in God and you lose your loved one, you have the confidence that you're going home to rest in a better place, you can say, yes, it is well. Glory be to God. Yes, it is well. Oh, somebody praise God. Amen. I want to join with the children. Amen. And grandchildren and great-grandchildren and friends who gather here today to say, it is well. She's gone home to rest. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. I understand, and I'm closing. I understand your grief today. The Bible said in verse 27, the latter part of the verse, it says, and the man of God said, let her alone, for her soul is vexed within her, and the Lord had hid it from me and had not told me. Oh, somebody praise the name of the Lord. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Verse 32 said, when Elisha was coming to the house, behold, the child was dead and laid upon his bed. Oh, praise be to God. Oh, praise be to God. Verse 35 and 36, and I'm closing right there. It said, then he returned and walked in the house to and fro and went up and stretched himself upon him. And the child sneezed 7 times. And the child opened his eyes. Verse 36 says, and he called Gehazi and said, call the Shunammite woman. So he called her, and when he was coming unto him, he said, take up thy son. Somebody give God some praise up in here. Yes, yes, yes. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Abba can witness up in here. And yes, though he were dead, yet shall he live. Somebody praise God. Amen. The living we talk about may not be continuously in this life, but praise God, after this life, there is another time to live. After this life, there is another time to live. And the only way you can live after this life is to ensure that you live correctly in this life. Living correctly in this life means that you need to have God in your life. Living correctly in this life means you need to have Christ in your heart. Living correctly in this life means that you need to live in love always. Oh God, the only love some of y'all knows when somebody hugging upon you. And most times that ain't no love. Sometimes it's what you can get from the somebody. Let me behave myself. Sometimes what you think is love is what I learned in school, is infatuation. Amen. But you need to ensure that you live your life correctly while you are here on earth. Because if you die without living how you are supposed to live, then there's no hope after you are gone. The Bible says that in the grave, who shall give you thanks? Stand with me, please. Put your hands together for the word of the Lord. This is my story. I want to pray for the immediate family members and children and grandchildren. And Brother Hezekiah, Can you come up here with me a little bit, sir? Oh, bless God. We're gonna you and I are gonna pray for the family. But your family, no? You say your auntie, right? Well, you look like a man who was about 90 up in there. Yeah, you look up in there, man. That's why I call Ezekiel for real, you know. Mm-hmm. This is my song.
praising my Savior all the day long.
My final comment to you that there is life in God. There is life in God. And I implore you, some of y'all think that church boring and Christian life boring. But let me tell you this, I've been doing this since I was 14. And don't let the baby face fool you. I soon reached great grandpa age now. And I ain't no joke. Amen. It is by God's grace. It is by God's grace. No bleaching cream. It is by God's grace that have brought me here this far. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. And I implore you that if you don't know God in your life, I implore you to accept him before you die. Bow your head with me. And Brother Hezekiah, we're going to pray for the family. Praise God. Loving God and our Father, we give you glory again. We give you praise and we give you honor. All power belongs unto you. Lord, the power of life and of death, it belongs in your hand. And so, Father, as we look to you today, about to send home your daughter back to where she came from. Because your word says, from the earth we came unto the earth, we must return. Lord, she can't hear the prayer. No, we don't pray for her because her time is expired. But we pray for those, God, who are still alive. Her children, her grandchildren. Lord, her great-grandchildren, or those, every other family member and friend, and friends who are here today. Lord, we ask in the name of Jesus that you'll put a covering over them. Mighty God, most of all, bond them together. Because, Lord, unity is strength. We pray, God, in your name that as we go from this place, you will go before us. Lord, as we live continuously in this life until you call us, I ask you in the name of Jesus, Father, to keep us under the covering of your mercies. Hear this, though, your servants cry. Let your blessings and peace be upon your people as we tell you thanks. In Jesus' name. Amen. Come on, put your hands together for the word of God again. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. At this time, I will hand over to the directors in the care of Jesus.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the family, I want to thank you all for coming and showing your support. As we do depart here today, we'll be making our way to Glenview Memorial Gardens, making a right onto Derry, a right onto Airport, a right onto Steeles, and a left-hand turn onto Highway 50. We'll be in section Trinity of the Garden. I'm going to ask those following ahead of us, please do not block the grave as we need enough room for the funeral fleet to arrive. And those traveling in procession, please put your four-way flashers on and you're following all rules and regulations of the road as we're not under police escort. As we depart here today, Pastor will lead us out, followed by the family and friends following behind him. Then the cast will come downstairs. I'm going to kindly ask you and thank you in advance for your cooperation to go directly outside, as we will need the pallbearer's assistance to put the casket into the coach. And on behalf of New Haven Funeral Center, we thank you for allowing us to serve you.
My life for all time. Mama. feels like food to my soul.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
You're always down for me, have always been around for me, even when I was bad. You've shown me right from my wrong.
Even him, we meekly beseech your Father to raise us from the debt of sin unto the life of righteousness. And when we shall depart this life, we may rest in him, as our hope is this, our mother, sister, doth. And that at the general resurrection in the last day, we may be found acceptable in thy sight and receive that blessing which thy well-beloved Son shall then pronounce to all that love and fear thee, saying, come, you blessed children of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world. Grant this, we beseech thee, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our mediator and redeemer. Can we all say amen? Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship, all right, of the Holy Ghost be with us all forevermore. Can we all say again?
Amen.
Amen. When we all
get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see
Jesus,
we will sing and shout the victory.
And if there remains such a place.